We are going to look at excretion and excretory system. What is excretion? Let's look at the definition on the board.
Excretion is the removal of metabolic waste from the body to avoid poison. Take note of this keyword, metabolic waste. In other words, the waste must come from body reactions going on in the body cells before the product can be regarded as excretory product. And the reason for removing the waste is to avoid the body from being poisoned. Now look further, I will see that the major excretory products in animals are the nitrogenous waste, such as ammonia, you see in the lower animals like amoeba, paramecium, and so on, urea or uric acid. Uric acid is produced by animals that are conserving water. So, because urea contains more water, they remove water completely from their own to form solid uric acid. Other nitrogenous wastes are carbon-4 oxide, produced from respiration in the cell. Excess water, breakdown of molecules in the body, and salts. Bile, produced from breaking down of red blood cells in the liver, and sweat, a product removed by the skin. Those excretory products removed by plants are grouped together as alkaloids and glycosides. Alkaloids are nitrogenous base, including the tannin, quinine, camphor, and so on. Then the glycosides as products like resin, gum, and mucilage, and so on. You can see why animals have specific organs and structure to remove waste products from the body. Plants do not have such specialized organs. So most respiratory products in plants are retained or are converted to harmless products, insoluble products, and stored in parts of the plant like leaves, flowers, fruits, bark of a tree, even the roots. So let's look at some of the excretory structures and organs. Excretory structures of organs in animals are kidneys are found in vertebrates for removal of nitrogenous waste like urea. Skin is used by protozoa and the amphibians and even man. Skin is being used to remove sweat in man, nitrogenous waste, carbon-4 oxide and so on in amphibian and so on. Lungs is regarded as a respiratory organ because we remove carbon-4 oxide through it. And group of animals like mammals, bears, amphibians, and reptiles that are using lungs use this organ to remove carbon-4 oxide and water in form of vapor from the body. Liver removes bile in mammals and bears. Other structures used by lower organisms to remove nitrogenous waste are nephridia by annelids, represented by earthworm here, Malpighian tubules in insects, and flame cells in flatworms. So, for understanding of excretory system, let us draw the kidney and the nephron. This is the diagram of urinary system in mammals. Now, we have the two kidneys located at the lower abdominal part, that is the lower trunk of the abdominal part of the body. So, the kidney, you can see them, they are not directly opposite each other, they are adjacent. The shape is a bean shape and is brownish when they are healthy. They are well supplied with blood vessel. This is the dorsal artery coming from the heart, supplying the kidney with blood through the renal artery. Then the blood supply to the kidney will be filtered and returned to the circulatory system through the renal vein. This one. This is the vein. This is the inferior vena cava returning blood from the lower part of the body to the heart. So this one, after filtering, it is this one that returns the blood to it. Why this one? This one returns blood to this one. These are the renal veins. Now, the heart is connected with these blood vessels to get blood filter and return. The filter urine by the kidney will be passed through the ureter into the urinary bladder. When the urinary bladder is filled, the sphincter, the thick round muscles here called sphincter, will relax and the fluid flows through the urethra to the outside. Take note, in male, the urine passes the same urethra as well as the semen. So, the male organ, the urethra is performing dual function for ejaculation of sperms and as well as for urination. Now let's look at the detailed structure. Take note of the structures on top of each of the kidney. They are adrenal glands. They produce adrenaline, which is a hormone. Now let's look at the internal structure of the kidney. The longitudinal section of mammalian kidney. Here, the kidney has been dissected longitudinally, revealing three major zones: the cortex, the medulla, and the pelvis. Now, the functional unit of a kidney is the nephrons, and they are in millions inside a kidney. When you look at the nephron carefully, the Bowman capsule is located on the cortex, while the convoluted renal tubule and the Ehlers loop, they are all in the medulla. Then the nephron joins to a bigger tube known as connective tube, which enters the pyramid of the pelvis, and its content is drained through the pelvis into the urethra to the urinary bladder. So this is the structure. The kidney, as explained earlier, is supplied with two blood vessels, one bringing in blood, the renal artery, and one taking out blood, the renal vein. So we are going to, let's enlarge this nephron and see the structure. This is the structure, the nephron, of a nephron. Starting with the Bowman capsule, the Bowman's capsule, cup-shaped structure, receiving blood, that is a branch of the renal artery, branching into anterior, supply blood to this Bowman capsule. On the Bowman capsule, it branches to capillaries and form bundles of capillary right on the Bowman's capsule. This bundle of capillary is known as glomerulus. The glomerulus and the Bowman capsule is sometimes referred to as, not sometimes, it's referred to as Malpighian body or Malpighian capsule. Let me write that one for you. Malpighian capsule. Now, because of the differences in the volume of afferent arterial and the blood vessel leaving the glomerulus, efferent arterial, this one is tinier than this. Blood that comes in generates pressure here and cause the materials in the blood to be forcefully filtered out of the blood. That is what we call ultrafiltration. Ultrafiltration. The filtrated material is now called glomerular filtrate. It is the filtrate that will be moving through this coiled renal tube, coiled to reduce the speed. And you can see that Even the renal tubule is well supplied with blood capillaries. These are blood capillaries around the renal tubule. So as it flows slowly through this coil renal tubule, the useful materials in the filtrate will be reabsorbed, that's the language, reabsorbed into the blood in the capillary. And the filtrate moves through the Ehlers loop, this curve. Here, the soft radicals are either be removed or added, depending on the pH of the body fluid. If the body fluid is getting acidic, all the acidic material in the filtrate will not be reabsorbed. Instead, is the basic material like calcium and hydrogen oxide, that's hydroxy ion, that will be reabsorbed to make the fluid getting more alkaline. So as the filtrate is now moving through this area, more water will be reabsorbed if the body does not need water. If the body does not need water, the water will not be reabsorbed. But if the body needs water, more water will be reabsorbed. And this is under the control of the brain. Under the brain, that is, the pituitary gland produces hormone known as antidiuretic hormone. This antidiuretic hormone controls the permeability of the permit of the renal tubule. In the presence of antidiuretic hormone, we allow the renal tubule to allow more water to be reabsorbed from the filtrate, and so the urine become more concentrated. But if, like the Ramadan time, when you are not sweating and you plenty water is in the body, this antidiuretic hormone will be suppressed, it will not be produced by the pituitary gland. So more water will not be reabsorbed. More water will even be added to the filtrate at this position and even in the connective tubule. So the urine that will come out will be very diluted. This is how the nephron help us to regulate our body environment by removing waste, controlling the pH of the body, and also control the amount of the water in our body. So the kidney carries out three major functions: excretory function, osmoregulatory function, and balancing of the pH level in the body. So let us examine some questions based on excretion. Let's look at the first question. The bone marrow capsule is located in which part of the mammalian kidney? A. Pelvis. B. Medulla. C. Pyramid. D. Cortex. If you understand the diagram of the kidney, you will see that the bone marrow capsule of the nephron is located at the cortex of the kidney. So answer to number one is D. Number two, we have the following machine. One, stomata to spirogyra. Two, alveoli to earthworm. Three, Malpighian tubules to mamma. And four, contractile vacuoles to protozoa. Now, what the examiner wants you to look at is which of them have the right structure for excretion correctly matched. So question two question is, which of the following is correctly matched? A is two. Two is alveoli to earthworm. Earthworm has no alveoli. B, one. One is stomata to spirogyra. As I said, spirogyra has no leaf, so it has no business with stomata. C, four. Four is contractile vacuoles to protozoa. That is correct. D, three. And three is Malpighian tubule to mamma. Mamma has kidney, not Malpighian tubule. Malpighian tubules are for insects. So answer to question two is option C. Option C is four, which is contractile vacuole to protozoa. Number three,
In mammals, the exchange of nutrients and metabolic products occurs in A. Lungs, B. Trachea, C. Nerve, and D. Ileum. Excretory product, the metabolic product is excretory product. It's not exchanged with food nutrients in the lungs. It's not also done in the trachea. It's not done in the ileum. So it's nerve. Nerve is body fluid where the cells take nutrients from the food and release carbon dioxide to the fluid. So answer is C. Number four, the structure of controlling the loss of water vapor in leaves is A. Palisade cell, B. Gas cell, C. Epidermal cell, D. Intercellular space. The structure for controlling the water to control the loss of water vapor. Water vapor is being lost from the leaf through the stomata. What structure in the stomata control the rate of the transpiration here? Answer is gas cell. So, answer to question four is option B, gas cell. Number five, ureter connects urinary bladder to A, liver, B, kidney, C, testes, D, ovary. Obviously, the answer is kidney. Ureter carries urine from kidney to urinary bladder.